in case you've missed my past couple months of absolute unadulterated thoughtery on Instagram, let me catch you up real quick. Lately, I've been really, really into working out. And because I've been enjoying nothing more than learning from other people who are better at getting in shape and know more about exercise and nutrition and things like that than I do, it is no surprise that I fell a little bit into the world of fitness influencers as well. And just as when I went to learn more and more about business, I discovered how many scams there are in the business influencer world, big shocker, in the fitness influencer world, it is the exact same thing. As it turns out, this entire concept of taking specific pieces of advice that really vary wildly based on things like industry or body type or personal situation and trying to apply a one-size-fits-all approach that you can sell on a big scale for large amounts of money as courses just for the sake of earning lots and lots of money through your impressionable fans, well, that is truly a concept that transcends industry, whether that's business education or learning about fitness and getting in shape. People are out here scamming! But what I was shocked to learn was that through following one particular fitness influencer and examining her scams, I would learn more and more about how to become a better business owner myself and what values I personally need to remember to take into the future of running my own company. So today, get ready, y'all, because we are going to be talking about Brittany Dawn. From fitness to fundamentalist, Brittany Dawn, the woman who scammed tons of her fans on Instagram, sold them fake subpar workout routines and fake diets and things like that, and then completely abandoned everything and decided to become a Christian influencer instead, because I guess that's what people do nowadays when they want a girl stop apologizing. They just say, oh, I did nothing wrong. I love Jesus. How can I have done anything wrong when I love Jesus? Would you say Jesus does something wrong? That's not how it works, Brittany. Stick around. We're gonna dive into all this shit. Let's go.
Get you some nuts.
There was lots of memes. Makes me wonder if I should take up lesbianism.
Chicago, you guys asked for it.
What's up, my fellow small business supporters? I'm Savvy. Welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome for the first time. Excuse my messy office today. I am a bit of a mess. On my gamer girl chair behind me, we have Sean Boston the Puppet. If you guys haven't heard of Sean Boston, he is a scammy influencer just like the people we cover on this channel. Only the difference is, he's not real. He's the villain of the novel that RK and I wrote together called Cancel Sean Boston, which is now available on Amazon in both ebook and paperback, and will soon be available in audiobook as well, so you can check that out linked in the description below if you like books about internet drama, which there aren't a ton of them, so this one might be your one chance. Anyway, we're planning to make like a silly movie adaptation of our book when we're in New Orleans in a couple weeks. Anyway, along with that, let me shout out a couple other channels that you guys need to subscribe to if you are interested in this topic we're going to be discussing today of Brittany Dawn. First of all, my friend Monica Hayworth. She is fantastic, and she did a three-part series on Brittany Dawn, first delving into her fitness course scam, then delving into her multi-level marketing involvement, and then finally talking about the Christian retreat that she's now selling to people. So definitely check out Monica's video. She did so much in-depth research, and the videos are fantastic. Monica, Jinguye. Second, I would like to shout out the channel Not the Good Girl. Her documentary style work that she's been doing recently has been fantastic, and she did this really in-depth documentary exposing Brittany Dawn, where she really delved into some of the implications of purity culture and this whole modesty only type of style that Brittany is now trying to promote to her fans. Today's video is going to have a specific focus, which is going to be on the business elements of Brittany's scams, and after studying those scams, what I was able to learn about how I can become a better business owner, and what we can all take away as ways to avoid the types of mistakes that Brittany made. Because we are focusing a little bit more on that business type of scope, this video isn't going to be going into some of the massive, really problematic topics that come up or surrounding Brittany Dawn, including the fact that she's married to a former cop who was fired from the police force for engaging in police brutality, or the fact that a lot of the purity culture, modesty only only dressing type of rhetoric relies a lot on body shaming and misogyny and things like that, or the fact that a lot of the stuff that she's been putting out there lately has had a lot of both racist and homophobic undertones. We're not even getting into that. There's so much to unpack about this woman, but because the scope of this video is narrow, I just wanted to let you guys know that all that shit is out there about Britney as well. I would recommend, again, checking out Monica or Josie from Not the Good Girls videos, as well as this past week on my second channel, Your Morning Guru, we did an entire week studying Britney Dawn. If you don't know, my second channel, we study a different guru or influencer every week. We try to live like them, not by engaging in scams or doing illegal shit, but we try to, if they have a book out, we read their books. If they have videos out, we watch their videos. We try to learn as much about them as possible, see if we can learn anything from them, whether that's something to improve ourselves or that's something to avoid and not to do. So we really went into exposing Britney this week. We now have a full week of live streams about her up on that second channel. So please go and check that out. Second channel, Your Morning Guru, is linked in the description below. We stream every single morning at 8 a.m. Central Time. So get you up in the morning with a live morning show. Lots of fun. So now let's talk a little bit about Britney Dawn and her scammy fitness courses. Right now we are on the website muscleandfitness.com and we are checking out this article that's called Fitness Influencer Britney Dawn Accused of Scamming Followers. Online courses reportedly never delivered what was promised. We've talked a lot about online courses and gurus who try to turn any skill they have into a course when they're not actually qualified to be teaching things. I will link up in the cards. Check out the video I did about this with the Recovering Hanbot, where we dove into what actually makes a good course versus what makes an influencer scam. Britney Dawn, a Dallas-based coach and fitness influencer, is facing backlash from followers after they paid for her online fitness and nutrition programs that were reportedly never customized to the individual as promised. Last April, and I believe this was last April as of 2019 because this actually happened a while ago and we're gonna see how she shifted from there. Last April, the Better Business Bureau started getting complaints from Dawn's followers about delays in receiving her customized online fitness programs, some which range in price from $45 to as high as $300. Followers who purchased the courses told the Better Business Bureau that they ordered customized programs but only received generalized ones. And when they tried to inquire with Dawn, she allegedly skirted around answering their questions. Dawn was also accused of deleting any critical comments on Instagram page and blocking customers, according to a report in the Insider and Better Business Bureau. So basically what happened was Britney Dawn was, you know, posting videos on her YouTube channel. She was posting photos on her Instagram. She was showing her transformation to becoming a super in shape person. She gave stories about overcoming eating disorders, and she talked about how she gained a lot of muscle, became super strong, became super in shape. And a lot of her fans were inspired by this. And from there, she offered this course where she said, okay, well, I am going to give you an individual personalized fitness plan and diet plan that will fit your personal fitness goals. Now, if you've ever spent like 5 minutes in any type of fitness world, you'll know that having those plans be individualized is super important because, well, for one, everybody has a completely different body type. I will give an example of myself. So for me, as I've talked about before, I have really bad OCD. And in the past, when I've tried, you know, calorie counting as a way to get in shape, to either eat at a surplus to gain muscle or at a deficit to lose fat, I realized that the way my brain fixates so hard on numbers sends me into weird OCD thought spirals to the point that I cannot stop from latching on to those numbers, which has caused me to go into eating disorders before. I spent a lot of my teenage years and my early 20s being very underweight, which I've gained a ton of weight back from now, and I'm now working on actually building muscle and getting into good shape. That was a huge problem for me, so I know I can't have a nutrition plan that involves counting calories. A nutrition plan that involves counting calories may be great for somebody else. I was just watching this channel the other day called Obese to Beast, and he was talking about how he went from being obese to getting super in shape and how he lost the weight and how he gained all this muscle. And part of that did involve counting calories, not necessarily at the beginning, but as he got more into his fitness journey, he did have to count calories. So for some people, that's going to work really well. And for other people, it's going to make the process just absolutely miserable. Here's another example. I also have really bad scoliosis. My spine's really twisted. I don't like to do squats with the bar because if I do like one wrong move, my back's going to be out of commission. I know people say if your form is correct, you won't hurt your back, which is true. However, if I mess up my form a little bit just by accident, my back's going to be out of commission for like a month. And I'm really not really willing to to take that risk. So I found a lot of other exercises that target similar muscle groups and things like that that I do instead for the sake of keeping my back protected against that type of risk. So people with different body types, people with various physical disabilities, just various things in general are going to require different workout plans, not to mention just people who have different fitness goals. Somebody like me who's looking to gain a lot of muscle and who's trying to get really strong is going to do something totally different than someone who's just looking to lose weight, or someone who's training for a triathlon is going to train in a different way than someone who's training for a weightlifting competition or something like that. So just your fitness goals in general are going to be completely different. So claiming that you're going to give each one of your clients an individualized plan, that you're going to check in with all of them, and then actually just giving them your one-size-fits-all approach is completely a scam. Customers took things even further by starting a petition, Stop Brittany Dawn Fitness Scams on change.org, that amassed nearly 8,600 signatures as of writing, and nearly 4,000 people joined a Facebook group to share their stories. I believe that petition has now, let's look at the petition. Well, that article is pretty old because the petition now has almost 16,000 signatures. In response to all the backlash against her online courses, Dawn released a statement on her YouTube channel on February 6th, acknowledging her mistakes and apologizing to followers who were dissatisfied with her product. Unfortunately, with being human, it comes learning from my mistakes, said a tearful Dawn, who said she has received hundreds of death threats. This is my heartfelt apology to move forward and make things right, and I please ask that the death threats end for my family and friends to be left alone from here on out. So I just want to be very clear about something. I don't support anyone harassing others on the internet. I even like to say, you know, don't send hate to anybody. So if you watch this video and you think Brittany Dawn is a scammer, which I personally do, and I think it would be totally justified if you did too, but if you're like, oh my God, I'm really mad at Brittany Dawn and you want to share my video, don't tag her in it. Don't interact with her. I criticize a lot of people and their business practices here, but I think it's a good practice not to tag people and not to say it to them directly, and especially not to threaten people and things like that. We can raise public consciousness of these topics and discuss them and educate people on them without sending harassment towards any specific person. So I agree that if she was receiving death threats, which Brittany Dawn's been shown to be kind of a liar a lot lately, so I don't know if she really was or not, but if she was, I do not condone that at all, and that would be absolutely wrong on the part of the people who did that. However, after Brittany apologized, you would think that if she truly reflected on what she'd done wrong and realized that she had wronged her customers, she would have tried to do anything possible to make things right, including issuing a refund. However, let's talk about what actually happened next. So this insider article is called "A Fitness Influencer Who Some Say Is a Scammer Still Hasn't Issued Full Refunds for Nutrition Programs Weeks After Followers Called Her Out." More than a month after fitness influencer Brittany Dawn lost followers and sponsors for scamming her customers, a claim levied at her in her comment section and in interviews with Insider, many are still waiting for a full refund. She has more than 500,000 Instagram followers, and she was the subject of complaints for years over her personal coaching and nutrition programs. While the programs, which cost up to $300, promised customized personal coaching sessions and nutrition plans, customers complained that they were all the same. Davis deleted critical comments and blocked users who complained, multiple followers told Insider. These complaints reached a critical mass in February when users formed a private group on Facebook called Brittany Dawn Fitness Complaints, which now has more than 5,000 followers. But Davis issued only partial refunds to many of her customers, who remain upset that they aren't receiving a full one. In the Facebook group, dozens of people have posted screenshots of her customer service representatives offering only a 50% refund instead of a full one, even though she didn't supply the services she advertised. She told Insider that she's handling customer complaints on a case-by-case basis. And what became a huge problem after this was not just that she didn't want to issue refunds, but that for a lot of customers to receive a refund from Brittany, she first required them to sign an NDA or non-disclosure agreement. So basically, if you wanted your money back on a course where you didn't get what you had actually paid for, she would require you to first legally agree that you were not allowed to talk about it. So basically trying to squash all potential negative reviews. let's take a look at what the Better Business Bureau has to say. I purchased one of Brittany's fitness programs and I was charged emailed workouts, but I was not assisted in other areas as promised. 2 years ago, I purchased a fitness program from Brittany Dawn. After my initial purchase, I waited 3 weeks without receiving one email from her. I finally reached out again and she did provide me with the workouts. However, that was about all she did. Because of the program I purchased, I was supposed to receive weekly updates and changes if needed to my macros and training regimen. When I would email her my check-in, she would rarely reply. When she did, she would answer questions I had with, "Girl, I have a YouTube video over this. Check the link," and that would be it. How is that helpful? Especially when she would preach in her Instagram stories how every girl and every body is different. Not only were my check-ins pretty much brushed off, I found out through a Facebook group that my personalized macros were exactly the same as hundreds of other girls. How is that possible? How is it that each and every one of us who came from different backgrounds, body types, builds, etc., had needed the exact same macros? Super fishy. This person says, "I purchased a 6-month training program and was not given the advice, guidance, or coaching I was promised. I purchased a 6-month training program and began it in January of 2017. I started experiencing issues and a lack of communication right off the bat. Brittany did not send my program right away as promised. After 3 weeks and 3 emails, I finally received my program. She also advertises and promises customized macros for every client. Upon joining a Facebook group, I learned that my macros were exactly the same as most of the girls in the group. Interesting. Brittany requires weekly check-ins with her clients, yet she never responds back to them. 1 week, I sent her a lengthy email with many questions, comments, and concerns about my food intake. She responded with one sentence and referred to me to a YouTube video of hers." Really? Her clients are just another opportunity for her to shamelessly promote her YouTube video. "Each and every time I asked her a question, I was told, check out my YouTube video on whatever topic." How is that coaching? How is that assisting and guiding someone on their health and fitness when I am constantly told to just watch a YouTube video? Her responding to emails quickly fizzled out too. Once I asked, "My question goes deeper than a vague answer on a YouTube video, can you help me with?" she quit answering my emails. My next check went in without a response. So did the following weeks, and the next one. I thought I'd try a month later. Nope. After the first month, she never responded to any emails or check-ins I would send. I was promised coaching and did not receive any. Shortly after all of these complaints began to mount, Brittany posted an apology video on her YouTube channel, which has since been deleted. But the basic idea of that video was that she mentioned something that really got me to start thinking about what I can learn from her. And what she said was, "I went into an industry with no instruction manual. I started my own business," and kind of talked about how she didn't really know what she was doing. She was doing all of these different roles in her business, including being the CEO, creating the coaching programs, trying to communicate with customers, and that she was new to it and ended up making a lot of mistakes because she didn't really know what she was doing going into it. And when I heard this, I realized that I could actually relate to a little bit of this, being someone who did start my own business without a business education, who was new to these concepts of, okay, wait, so how do I do these taxes now? Okay, so I gotta do some customer service. Oh, this person didn't receive the full order. Oh no, what do I do? And things like that. Suddenly I was in a place where I was like, I might make a big mistake. I might not know what to do. But basically she made an apology video where she said that, and then she later deleted the apology video, I think as an attempt to rebrand. Because once Brittany Dawn decided to get away from the whole fitness influencer world after that wasn't really working out for her, first, she had a brief stint in promoting MLM products. Monica Hayworth has a fantastic video about this. Highly recommend you check it out. But in that video, Monica talked about how Brittany, for a little while, first would like promote Arbonne makeup and things like that and have a little swipe up link in her Instagram story being like, yeah, my foundation's from Arbonne. It's great. Arbonne is an MLM company. I've done a video on them. I'll link it up in the cards. And then on top of that, for a long time, she promoted Melaleuca on her Instagram story. She had, you know, affiliate links and such for Melaleuca to profit off of this MLM company. And again, on Your Morning Guru, we dove into Melaleuca a lot and what that company is. But it's basically an MLM that tries to disguise itself as, no, we're more like a Costco, we're a membership shopping club. Except they sell their memberships to people as like, you have to buy the membership from someone else. You have to be referred by another person. You can't just join it as a member. And then as someone who owns the membership to the shopping for the products, you're supposed to build a downline. Like, it's an MLM trying to disguise itself as like a Costco, which is ridiculous. So Brittany Dawn tried to do the little MLM boss babe hustle for a little bit. And then when that didn't work out, she has moved to her newest grift, which is selling religious retreats. And the reason that I think these things are grifts is that once she moves on to her next business venture, the previous one is like completely deleted. It's almost impossible to find stuff about her MLM's sales because it was like all in her Instagram stories that were gone after 24 hours, and then she's deleted everything. She's also deleted her fitness Instagram. She has her like personal Instagram now and her personal Instagram for account called She Lives Freed, which is about her religious retreat. So let's go. So here is Brittany Dawn's website. We're on brittanydawn.com, and she has a few options for things you can do on her website. Those things are retreats, home, about, or lash extensions. So a little bit different from the fitness industry. She's completely changed types of careers now. If you go to her about page, you can't get in without a password, which is sus. She also sells presets for her Instagram photos. So like that's the thing you can buy is like her pre-made filters. If anyone here sells Instagram presets, I don't want to bash you without understanding you. So please let me know what this industry is about, because I just don't understand how Instagram presets can be a thing you sell when like each photo's lighting is going to require different editing. Like maybe if you're someone who regularly takes photos in all the same natural light, or if your home gets a lot of natural light or something, but a lot of my photos, because my apartment's basically like a cave, a lot of my Instagram photo editing is just like making it look like there's any light in the picture at all so you can see it. So I feel like a lot of people's Instagram presets would just look like shit on my photos. So I don't understand how these can work, but if anyone knows, let me know. But she's selling these for like $12 for one Instagram filter. That seems a little ridiculous to me. And it seems, again, outside of her. She was selling fitness courses, then she sold MLM products. Now she sells religious retreats, Instagram presets, and lash extensions. She sells false eyelashes to glue on. So this just seems like a very disjointed business. I don't understand how any of it's. So anyway, this is the religious retreat that she's doing right now. She had one already in 2021 during the pandemic. The religious retreat cost $650, about the price that a lot of gurus charge for their conventions. I mean, she's charging less than Grant Cardone, I'll give her that. But a lot of gurus are charging prices like that for their conventions, which again, I think is too high of a price for what that is too. But then for this, it's like you get even less. It's 3 days long, right? The third day is only breakfast, so you're only there in the morning anyway. The first day is only dinner, so you're only there at night. So it's really like one full day and then two half to third of days. And what you mainly do is like church services, which is fine, but why are you paying so much for that when you could just go to church? So anyway, she has this retreat that she's selling. It seems like a small group of people. It looks like everyone has a fun time, so I won't knock it, but it comes across like she is trying to find a new way to make money, and the religious influencer world is the new way. I feel like we see this shit a lot with like when an influencer gets in big trouble, they suddenly are like, oh my God, I found Jesus. I love Jesus so much. I'm so religious. You can't criticize me. We've seen that with so many people. Nikki Filippi is probably the biggest one I can think of where, you know, I did a video on her. I'll link it up in the cards. I'm not going to say out loud what she did. It was horrible, but she did something horrible. And then after that, all of her videos following that up were like, so I've been talking to Jesus a lot and I've been praying a lot. And it's like, I think religion can be wonderful for people who it enhances your life, for building community, for, you know, learning to empathize with other people and for studying historical, interesting stories. I think there can be a lot of benefits to religion, but I think that there are too many people who just use it as a cop-out, and it really seems like she's doing that here. So I guess from here, we can transition into the two major takeaways of what I learned to become a better business owner from looking at Brittany Dawn's failings. The first one is to stay focused. I think this is a good transition from what we just talked about, right? Because we saw how Brittany Dawn was a fitness influencer who became a religious influencer. And in between there, she did some MLM stuff, and she also sells some lash extensions, and she also sells some Instagram presets. So she's a little bit all over the place. And when most people think of her, because she doesn't have one focus, what most people seem to think of is, oh, isn't she that lady that scammed people? Other than that, there isn't really like a clear focus or a clear mission to her business. And that got me to thinking about how to keep all of my stuff focused, especially when I am operating in a couple different industries. As a lot of you guys know, I run Forever Home Friends. My company produces books, plushies, and more based on real rescue dogs and their journeys to adoption. We're currently getting ready to work on our fifth character, which is going to be a cat. We're going to vote on who the cat's going to be, and voting's going to start in November, so stay tuned for that. But anyway, that's my company, right? And I started that because of my love for books and my love for dogs. However, I also have other books that I put out. I mentioned Cancel Sean Boston earlier. I write about a lot of different topics and I make these YouTube videos, and sometimes I worry that things are going to end up all over the place. Well, I've realized that my passion kind of connects when we have books and business and where those two things can intersect. So for me, my passion is a lot about disrupting the publishing industry, looking beyond massive publishing corporations, supporting the small businesses and small presses of the publishing world, and then also looking into the scams that a lot of business gurus put out to take advantage of small business owners and newer entrepreneurs and things like that. So it's all about trying to be an ethical business owner. And I know I'm not perfect. I know that my business probably could be doing better in terms of like environmental sustainability. That's a whole other topic. But my point is it helps keep me focused on my mission is to produce books and to discuss business, and to especially look at the places where those intersect. And that's what's gotten me thinking about doing a lot of videos. Like, I did a video criticizing the company Simon & Schuster recently from a business angle and talking about that. I've done videos on Usborne Books, which is the MLM company that sells books, talking about how I don't like it that a predatory company is operating in the bookselling world and things like that. So I try to stay focused. If I turned around and was like, actually, I'm selling lash extensions now, I feel like that would be a little bit out of left field, but who knows? But that's my point, is trying to keep my business focused and trying to keep it with one solid mission rather than very disjointed. The second thing, and this is where I think the major, most important takeaway comes from, is the importance of always being open to feedback. And this is a thing I've talked about a lot on my channel before, especially when I've criticized authors who have not taken reviews very well, like Gabby Hanna. I did a video about how she was mean to Rachel Oates after getting a bad review of her poetry book, and how Gabby was an example of someone who wasn't able to take criticism about her work. For me, being able to take criticism about my work, being able to analyze what my customers say and what they want is massively important. Hello, Chewy. Hello, buddy. Are you a good boy? Are you a good boy? One of the major mistakes that Brittany made in this case was that she didn't take in any of the criticism that her customers were giving her. When she did that apology video and said, I was new to running a business. I was trying to learn this all as I went. I had no instruction manual. To an extent, some of the things she said resonated with me. And I know from the outside that feels like, oh, she's making excuses. And maybe she was. Maybe she was. I definitely don't forgive her for what she did. But I also was able to relate to it a little bit as somebody who is running a business, but went into it without a specific business education, who is learning things as I go, and who has made mistakes, who's put out products that I'm like, I mean, I haven't put out any scam products, but I've put out some products, some merch items that later I'm like, nah, that wasn't the best merch item. Like, customers didn't really like that one, and that's okay. I can take it off. I can add a different item instead or something. But I definitely went into it having a lot to learn and knowing that one of my greatest fears is disappointing my customers. One of my biggest fears is somebody saying, this absolutely sucked. I had a terrible experience with this. I wish I didn't pay for this item or something like that. And that is bound to happen to an extent because not everybody's going to like a product that you put out. But I noticed from what Brittany was saying that she was new to this. She was learning it as she went. This would have been a key time for her to take in that criticism. However, what we saw that she actually did was block negative comments, ban people, delete the comments, close herself off to anything negative that customers had to say. And because of that, customers got more and more upset, when in reality, if she had just after those first few negative pieces of feedback said, okay, wait a second, maybe I'm doing this all wrong. I mean, this is me giving a good faith assumption and assuming that she wasn't scamming people on purpose. Maybe she was scamming them on purpose. Maybe she thought she could get away with it. Or maybe she did just make a genuine mistake. Who knows? But let's just say, on the off chance that what happened was she did want to give people personalized plans and then ended up getting so many clients she wasn't able to handle it, what I think would have been a lot better for her to do when she started getting some of that feedback, like, hey, you're not really responding to me. Hey, this isn't really personalized to me, would be to say, you know what? I'm going to reflect on myself and realize that I, as one person, am not capable of handling this many clients, and if I have this many clients, then maybe I need to hire more trainers to come on and take some of those clients. Or maybe I have to say, you know what, I'm going to refund you the money and transfer you to a different trainer of somebody that I know. Because that would be a way for her to realize where her own limitations lie and then take in that feedback from her customers. So I think this really just reinforced the importance of always staying open to feedback, even when it's not something you want to hear, even when it's something that hurts a little bit or is something that doesn't really feel that right to you because you're like, oh no, I thought I was doing well. It's important as a business owner to keep yourself open to that criticism because at the end of the day, people say the customer is always right. And yeah, sometimes the customer isn't always right. Sometimes the customer is an asshole. But at the end of the day, if a ton of customers are saying something, an entire group of customers is probably right. And it's important to keep in mind that what we're selling is not for us. Otherwise, we would just be giving it away, right? If she's just doing fitness training because she loves fitness training so much, she's doing it to make money, meaning that the person who's paying for it has to be the focus, not herself. And that's something that's good to keep in mind every time we go into business. I wrote about this in my book, Savvy Business Owner, too, where I said, when I was first developing the mission statement for Forever Home Friends, it was very easy to be like, okay, why do I sell these books? Why are people gonna buy these books? Why am I writing books about dogs? And it could be very easy to say, well, because I love dogs, or well, because I love books, but I'm not the person buying them. Why does the customer love dog books? And that's when I thought about, okay, maybe because dogs can tell a story in a way that can connect with a child in an empathetic way while being accessible to their emotions without taking on too heavy of topics in a serious way and keeping it cute and things like that. And I was able to think about how that could frame from a customer's perspective. Check this out real quick. You guys are actually gonna be really surprised to see this. I got these sweatpants and they say choose joy. I think no one ever thought they'd see me wearing anything that says choose joy, but let me tell you why I got these. And this ties into the message that I wanted to say real quick. So I got these sweatpants, let's say choose joy, from a small business. It's called The Shop Forward, and I wanted to support this business more after they had sent me a bunch of stuff for free. I actually shouted them out and talked about their whole business in my video called The Author to Business Guru Pipeline. I'll link it up in the cards. But they sent me a bunch of stuff for free and had shouted me out on their podcast and things like that. So I thought, this is a wonderful small business. Let me look more. I'd like to support them some more. They also give back to charity. I love it. And I found that they had all the stuff that said choose joy. Now you guys may remember that choose joy is a piece that we often saw on Rachel Hollis's merch. She had these shirts that said choose joy. She was selling choose joy merch everywhere she went. I used to be incredibly critical of choose joy because I was like, well, you can't choose to be joyful because there's a lot of other factors that go into play. And I related it a lot to mental health and mental illness and how a lot of times when you are dealing with mental illness, you really can't choose your emotions. And I still stand by that. And I still don't think choose joy is that great of a saying. So the reason that I got these sweatpants is not that I necessarily love the choose joy message or what it stands for. But it's because when I did my review of Rachel Hollis's Rise conference on my channel, I interviewed two former attendees of the conference, one of them who had been an attendee at the top level, paying like $2,000 for a ticket. She was really into all the stuff and was now talking about why she didn't really like Rachel Hollis and her message as much anymore. And this woman told me that while she agreed with a lot of what I said in my videos, she actually had disagreed with my criticism of Choose Joy. And she talked about how Choose Joy had actually been a really powerful message for her and had been really helpful to her while she was going through cancer. But at the same time, you know, I also read the book Brightsided, which I've also reviewed on this channel, which talked about how the Choose Joy type of message, Barbara Ehrenreich, the author, how that message was detrimental to her while she was fighting cancer. So it's a sign, I guess, of how different messages work for different people. But the reason that I wanted to get something with the Choose Joy message on it is not that I am going to choose joy or anything like that, but rather because this person telling me during an interview how she disagreed with something that I said and thought that the message resonated with her differently was a reminder to me to choose listening to my audience above everything else. Because I don't want to get stuck in an echo chamber. I don't want to get stuck in a group of people who say, yes, I agree with you. Yes, I agree with you. It's nice to be agreed with sometimes, but I also like it when someone challenges my views and says, yeah, you know what, Savvy? I like your videos, but I think you had the choose joy thing wrong. And maybe I had it wrong. Maybe I didn't have it wrong. I think it's different for everyone. But these sweatpants are now like a reminder of like, yeah, you know what? It's going to be different for everyone, and I can't give a one-size-fits-all recommendation to anything. Everyone's going to interpret things differently, and disagreeing with people that you like is okay, and criticizing people you like is okay, and agreeing with people you don't like sometimes is okay. And I think that that's something that could have saved Britney from her downfall in this case if she had listened to someone disagree with her and say, yeah, you know what? You know what? Maybe there's some merit to what you're saying. Maybe I need to analyze my own beliefs a little more. Maybe I need to look a little more into what I'm doing here. Anyway, I'd really like to hear your guys' thoughts on my takeaways from the whole Britney Dawn situation in the comments below. Did you guys take away anything similar from this situation? Did you take away anything different? What are your thoughts on the entire thing that's going on? Again, don't forget that if you want more information about all the stuff Britney Dawn's been involved with, because this video was not even the tip of the iceberg, please check out the videos that Monica put out and the videos that Josie, not the good girl, put out, and check out the entire week we did examining her on our show, Your Morning Guru. I appreciate you guys being here. I am currently working on the next Deep Dave, so if you're looking for a new Deep Dave video, it'll probably be out next week, so stay tuned. I'll see you guys again soon. In the meantime, please keep on supporting small businesses, and have a fantastic Friday. Bye!
Get you some nuts.
There was lots of memes. Makes me wonder if I should take up lesbianism.
Chicago.
You guys asked for it.